we are going to discuss a second problem in stiffness matrix method, that is frame problem. Let's see the problem. This is the problem. They given hinged support at A, then again B and C, fixed support at D. Again they given one UVL at C and D. Value is 10 kN per meter. Then this is the UVL which is acting. Then 30 kN acting at this in horizontal direction. Then length 1.5 meter and 3 meter. Then I value for AB is 1.5. then one more load is acting towards this side, that is right to left, that value is 20 kN, 2.5 meter, again 2.5 meter. Then at this BC, 40 kN per meter is acting. Next, degree of freedom, that is 3 degree of freedom at theta A, 1 degree of freedom, theta B, 2nd degree of freedom, at theta at C, that is theta C, 3rd degree of freedom. Therefore 3 degree of freedom, theta A, comma theta B, comma theta C. Let's draw the degree of freedom diagram. Same diagram I am drawing again. I will provide all the fixed supports, but we are going to provide 1 degree of freedom here, that is theta A, 2nd degree of freedom, theta B, 3rd degree of freedom, theta C. Now the first thing what we have to do is we have to provide all the support as fixed support. Our intention is to calculate all the fixed end moment. So I will provide, assume all the support as fixed support. Then I will apply all the given load again. The given here UDL, that is 40 kN per meter. Then they given one more UVL, this point A, B, C, D, and this is E. This is the UVL, that value is 10 kN per meter. Then they given one horizontal load acting, that is 20 kN. Distances are 2.5 meter, 2.5 meter. Again this length, that I value is 2i, I value is 2i, then length is 6 meter, then this is 6 meter. This I value is 2i, 6 meter, then 6 meter, one horizontal load is acting at a distance of 1.5 meter, 3 meter, I value 1.5i, then 30 kilo Newton. Let's calculate all the fixed end moment, that is FEMs, fixed end moments. First beam, that is MFAB, is equal to, if you have any horizontal load, it is better to draw the diagram immediately to avoid the confusion. I will draw like this, that is A, B, load is acting towards this side, that is 30 kilonewton, then 1.5 meter, then one distance is 3 meter. So MFAB is minus 30 into 1.5 into 3 square divided by 4.5 square. Again MFBA is equal to plus 30 into 3 into 1.5 square divided by 4.5 square. If I do the calculation, minus 30 into 1.5 into 9 divided by 4.5 square value is minus 20 kilonewton meter. Again one more, 30 into 3 into 1.5 square divided by 4.5 square, that is 10 kilonewton meter. Now I am going to the next beam, that is MFBC, that is minus 40 into WL square by 2L. MFCB, that is plus 40 into 6 square divided by 2L, that is minus 40 into 36 divided by 2L, that is minus 120 kilonewton meter. Then one more is 40 into 36 divided by 12, that is plus 120 kilonewton meter. Let's go to other beam, that is MFCE, that is UBL. Therefore at lower value, less value, that is minus 10 into WL square by 30, then load is heavy, that is higher load value, the here 0, that is minus 10 into 6 square divided by 30 WL square by 30. Then MFCE is equal to plus 10 into 6 square divided by 20. If I do the calculation, 10 into 36 divided by 30 is equal to minus 12 kilonewton meter. Then 10 into 36 divided by 20 is equal to plus 18 kilonewton meter. Now we have to calculate another fixed end moment, that is MFCD. So if you want to calculate MFCD, MFCD, so first draw that figure. So this is C, I will take this as D. So I will draw in this way, this is C, this one is D. Apply the fixed end moment at these two support, then load is, if I consider C and D, therefore load is acting like this, that is 20 kilonewton, therefore 2.5 and 2.5 meter, therefore value is MFCD is equal to minus 20 into L value, that is 5 meter, minus 10 5 divided by 8, that is minus 20 into 5 divided by 20 into 5 divided by 8, that is minus 12.5 kilonewton meter. MFDC is equal to plus 12.5 kilonewton meter, plus 12.5 kilonewton meter. Our next step is, that is P1 dash matrix, that is P dash matrix. So if I want to calculate P dash matrix, let's P1 dash, P2 dash, P3 dash. So to find that P1 dash, we taken our first coordinate is this one. This is coordinate 1, second coordinate, and third coordinate. At 1, that is MFCD, A, B. If I consider our coordinate 2, it is having MF, MF A, B, MF B, A and MF B, C. Okay, if I consider coordinate 2, MF B, A and MF B, C. MF B, A plus MF B, C. Our coordinate is here, that is 3, that is MFCB, MFCB plus MFCD, MFCD plus MFCE, MFCE. Let's see the value. MFAB we already calculated, minus 20. MFBA that is plus 10, MFBC that is minus 120, MFCB plus 120, MFC, MFCD we calculated here, that is minus 12.5, then last one MFCE, MFCE is minus 12, therefore this value is minus 20, that is 10 minus 120, that is minus 110, minus 110, then last value, that is 120 minus 12.5 minus 12, that is 95.5. Now we have to calculate one more matrix, that is P1, P2 and P3. As we know, this matrix will be generated if there is any cantilever beam. If I see the entire figure, there is no cantilever beam, therefore all the values are 0. Now we have to do P1 minus P1 dash, P2 minus P2 dash, P3 minus P3 dash. So if I want to do that one, that is 0 minus of minus 20, again 0 minus of minus 110, again 0 minus of 95.5, that is equal to 20 plus 110 minus 95.5. This is our P1 minus P1 dash matrix. Now we have to, next step is we have to find stiffness matrix. Stiffness matrix. So to do the stiffness matrix, first what I will do is applying, let's take this one. Okay. Applying, we need displacement at coordinate 1, that is theta a is equal to 1. Let's draw that figure. So I will draw the frame, entire frame like this. Okay, I will draw all the supports what they given like this. Okay, so this is also I will take fixed support, but this I will take hinged support. I have to apply clockwise moment. If I apply the clockwise moment like this, it's going to rotate this way. So this one I will take K11, that is force at 1 due to unit displacement at 1. Again, if I see here, this why I will take K21, that is force at 2 due to unit displacement at 2. Again, third one K31, that is force at 3 due to unit displacement at 3. Now if I want to calculate K11, that is equal to K11 is equal to 2 into E into I, they given, that is 1.5 I. For this 1.5 I, for this is I, again this is 2 I. Okay, that is 2 into 1.5 I divided by length of this beam, that is 4.5 meter. That length of this beam, that is 4.5 meter, into, that is, we are providing unit displacement at this moment, that is 2 into theta A. Theta A is nothing but 1, theta B value is 0. So if I do this calculation, that is 2 into 1.5 divided by 4.5 into 2, that is 1.33 pi. again I have to calculate K21, so I have to consider this one, like coordinate 2, that is point B, this is point A, B, C, then D, and this is E. I have to consider point B. So if I see that one, two beams are there, this is the one beam, then one more beam is this one. Therefore 2 into E into I value is 1.5 I for this beam, that is 1.5 I, divided by length is 4.5 meter into 2 into theta B, but theta B, only theta E is 1, theta B is equal to 0, plus 1. Therefore our value will be 2 into 1.5 divided by 4.5 into 1, that is 0.67 EI. again if I want to calculate K31, that means there is no deflection in this beam, there is no deflection here also, there is no deflection, directly we can take this as 0. So now further if I continue this problem, I have to calculate other stiffness matrix terms, that is next we can take applying unit displacement at 2. That means if I draw the figure, first I will draw the entire frame, whatever the given. So I will apply all the supports as fixed support. Now I have to do unit displacement at here. Just you have to remember, if I apply one clockwise moment, so if I apply this one, this is going to rotate in this way, again this is going to rotate in this way, there is no rotation at this other junction. This is A, B, then C, E and D. So this is 1.5 I, okay, then total length is 4.5 meter, again 6 meter, this is 5 meter, this is 2 I, again 6 meter. Now this one I will take K, this is our first rotation point, that is first coordinate, this one. So this I can take K12, that is unit force as 1 due to unit displacement at 2. This I can take K22, force at 2 due to unit displacement at 2. Then finally third one I can take K32, that is force at 3 due to unit displacement at 2. Now if I want to calculate K12, so that is 2 into E into I value is 1.5 I, divided by length of that beam, that is 4.5, into 2 into theta A. Theta A is equal to 0. Here if I am applying unit displacement at B, means theta B is equal to 1. Therefore 2 into theta, that is 0, plus theta B is equal to 1. So if I do that calculation, 2 into 1.5 divided by 4.5 into 1, that is 0.67 EI. Then again I will go to K22, I will go to this point. If I see that one, both the beams are rotating, therefore 2 into E into, first I will consider this beam, that is 1.5i divided by length of that beam, that is 4.5 into 2 into theta B, that is 1, plus 1 into theta A, that is 0. Again if I see that one, this is also rotating, therefore plus 2 into E into, I is I only, there is no changes in the I value, divided by length of the beam is 6 meter into 2 into theta B, theta B is 1, 2 into 1 plus theta C, theta C is 0. If I do that calculation, 2 into 1.5 divided by 4.5 into 2, this value, plus 2 into 2 divided by 6. Therefore, ultimately you will get 2 into EI. Next, I have to calculate K32. K32 is equal, if I see that one, 3 beams are connecting at this point, but rotation I can see only in this beam. Therefore 2 into E into, I value is 1 only, therefore I divided by length is 6 meter into 2 into theta C, 2 here theta B is equal to 1, theta C is equal to 0, therefore 0. Therefore theta again into theta B is 1, therefore 2 by 6 is equal to 0.33 EI. Okay, then finally I calculated 6 stiffness matrix terms. I have to calculate 3 more terms. So for that I have to apply unit displacement. Let's write applying unit displacement at 3. That means if I see this one, if I see my main figure, this is my problem theta C, that means theta C is equal to 1. So I will draw that figure, same thing, nothing changes, draw every frame like this, in this way, provide all support as fixed support. What I have to do is I have to provide rotation here. Okay, if I provide that rotation, this beam is going to rotation, this beam is going to rotate like this, again this beam is going to rotate like this, and finally one more beam is going to rotate like this. So this is K13, that is force at 1 due to unit rotation at 3. Then again this is K23, then finally this one K33. I will write all the length and I value, 4.5 meter, 1.5 I, this is 6 meter I only, this is 5 meter I only, this is 6 meter, I value is 2i. So let's start with the calculation, that is K13. If I see that one, there is no rotation in this beam, directly I can take this as 0. Next I will go to K23, this is K23. If I see that one, I can see the rotation in this beam. So I will start with the calculation, 2EI divided by length is 6 meter into 2 into theta B, this is A, B, C, d and this is e, 2 into theta b, 2 into 0, theta b value is 0, plus theta c, that is 1, theta c is equal to 1, therefore this value will be 2 by 6, that is 0.33 EI. Now I will calculate K33 value. So for that, if I see that one, I can see the rotation in all the three beams. So this calculation will be little lengthy. Let's see how to do that one. That is 2EI, I will consider this beam first, into divided by 6 into 2 into theta c value is 1 plus theta b value is 0. Again I will consider this beam, that is CD, plus 2EI divided by length is 5 meter into 2 into theta c value is 1, theta d is 0. Again I will consider this beam, that is 2 into 2EI divided by length is 6 meter into 2 into theta c, 2 into 1, theta e value is 0. Therefore if I do this calculation, 2 by 6 into 2 plus 2 by 5 into 2 plus 2 into 2 into 2 divided by 6, I will get 2.8 EI. So these are the value. So I get all the terms in our stiffness matrix. Okay, now let's next step is, what we have to do is these are the terms. I have to write combine all the terms, then I have to write my stiffness matrix, that is K is equal to EI is common. So first K, I calculated here K11, that is 1.33, then I calculated K21, that is 0.67, then K31, that is 0, then we calculated K12, that is 0.67, again K22, that is 2, then again K32, that is 0.33, then finally we calculated K13, that is 0, then K23, that is 0.33, then finally K33, that is 2.8. okay, next we have to write stiffness equation. Stiffness equation is nothing but delta is equal to K inverse into P1 minus P1 dash matrix. So theta, delta is nothing but our unknowns, that is theta A, theta B and theta C. Our K inverse matrix is nothing but 1 by EI into 1 point, I again write that stiffness matrix, whatever I calculated here, then 0.33 0.33, then 2.8. Now then our P1 minus P1 dash matrix, we already done that one, that is here. So directly I will write that one, minus 95.5. Next what you have to do is, just you have to do these things, this calculation. So I will go to use matrix function in calculator, dim first matrix, order is 3 into 3, just I will add the all the terms. 7 2.33, again 0.33 and 2.8. again at I will add one more matrix, that is matrix B, this one. So order is 3 × 1, values are 110 minus 95.5. Now I have to do the multiplication, so this is inverse. Okay, therefore shift mat 3, first matrix inverse inverse into second matrix, so mat B, so we will get the answer, that is theta A theta B theta C is equal to 1 by EI into minus 19.41, 68.38, then minus 41.72, 41.42.17, 42.177, 68.47, some small changes will be there. Okay, these are the values what I got in the calculation, 19.45, 68.47, 68.47. I write again 1 by EI into minus 19.45, 68.47 minus 42.177. Okay, next we have to do, next we have to calculate final moment, that is nothing but slow deflection equation. Okay, for that I'll start with MF AB. I have to refer the figure first, MF MAB. So MAB is equal to first MF AB minus 20 plus 2 into EI value, that is 1.5 by I divided by length is 4.5 meter into 2 into theta A, 2 into minus 19.45 divided by EI plus theta B. Theta B is nothing but 68.47, that is equal to minus 20 plus 2 into 1.5 by 4.5 into 2 into minus 19.45 plus 68.47. Our value is minus 9.95. This is also minus 0.286 kilo Newton. Again MBA is equal to MBA MFBA, that is 10, 2 into 1.5 by I divided by 4.5 into theta B, that is 68.47 divided by EI into 2 minus 19.45 divided by I, that is 10 plus 2 into 1.5 divided by 4.5 into 68.47 into 2 minus 19.45, that is equal to 88.23 kilo Newton. मीटर। अगेन एम बी सी इज इक्वल टू एम बी सी इज इक्वल टू माइनस 120 प्लस 2 ई आई एम बी सी बी सी वैल्यू इज 6 मीटर इंटू 2 इंटू टीटा बी दैट इज माइनस 42.17 2 इंटू 68.38 2 इंटू 68.47 डिवाइडेड बाई ई आई प्लस माइनस 42.177 डिवाइडेड बाय ई आई। सो इफ आई डू दैट कैलकुलेशन माइनस 120 प्लस 2 बाई 6 इंटू 2 इंटू 2 बाई 6 इंटू 2 इंटू 68.47 माइनस 42.177 we get minus 88.32 kilonewton meter. MCB is equal to plus 120 plus 120 MCB is this one that is 2 EI divided by 6 into 2 into minus 42.177 plus 68.47 that is 120 plus 2 by 6 in 2 by 6 into 2 into minus 42.177 plus 68.47 that is 114.70 kilo newton meter. Again I am going to do MCE MFCE is equal to minus 12 plus 2 EI divided by length of that beam 2 into 2 EI therefore into 2 divided by length is 6 meter. Then theta c is equal to 2 into minus 42.177 plus theta d is equal to 0. Each thing having EI values. Okay, 0. If I do that calculation, minus 12 plus 4 by 6 into 2 into minus 42.177. So we'll get minus 68.236 kilonewton meter. Again I have to do MEC. MEC this is EC. That is plus 18 plus 2 EI into 2 divided by 6 into 2 into 0 minus 42.177 divided by EI. Therefore 18 plus 2 into 2 divided by 6 into minus 42.11177. We will get the value okay now minus 10.118 kilonewton meter. Then finally MCD is equal to we calculated fixed end moment फिक्सड एंड मोमेंट इज माइनस 12.5 प्लस सो एम सी डी देयरफॉर 2EI डिवाइडेड बाय 5 मीटर इंटू 2 इंटू टीटा सी वैल्यू इज माइनस 42.117 डिवाइडेड बाय EI प्लस 0. Then finally MDC is equal to our fixed end moment is 12.5 plus 2 into EI divided by 5 into 2 into 0 minus 42.177 divided by EI. So if I do these two calculation, minus 12.5 plus 2 by 5 into 2 into minus 42.117 will get minus 46.24 kilo newton meter. Then last value 12.5 plus 2 by 5 into minus 42.11177 is equal to minus 4.37 kilonewton meter for this bending moment. For this final moments, we have to draw the bending moment diagram.